In the last class, we have seen about constants, variables and expressions. This is a continuation of the last class only. In today's class, we will be discussing about different kinds of operators and their hierarchies. So, first we will be discussing about arithmetic operators, then about relational operators, then about logical operators. Arithmetic operators. So, arithmetic operators include your addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, doing exponents, unary plus, unary minus, and so on. So let us take an example. So here we are considering p equal to 3, q equal to 2. So let us consider these two variables p and q in our MATLAB command window and do all these arithmetic operations. So p equal to 3, q equal to 2. Here the first operation is p plus q. So obviously you will get 5. Then we have p minus q, 1. Next is multiplication. For multiplication, we are going to use star mark. So for that, you will be clicking shift 8. So if I want to get p into q, 3 into 2 is 6. So not only this, we may also be using p dot into q. So dot operator is used so as to do element wise operations. So in case p and q are not single element variables, but they may be a vectors or matrices. In that case, by using dot operator, we'll be performing element by element operation. Here, because b and q are both single element variables, obviously the answer will be the same. And then coming to division, in division we have two types of division. One is right division and the left division. So right division we always do perform p forward slash q. This is your obvious right division. In right division, 3 by 2 you will get 1.5. Now we have another type of division called left division, which we might not have used frequently. This is p backslash q. If you are using backslash, it means that it's a left division in which the operation will be nothing but this operation is equal to p inverse. First we are finding inverse of p and then multiplying with q. It is as if we are multiplying inverse of p with q. Let us see what happens. It shall be 3 inverse into 2, that is 2 by 3, 0.667. Next, we have exponent. So, we can do p power q, 3 power 2, that will be 9. You may also do p dot power q. Here also, we mean to say that it is element wise operation. Next, we have unary operators. So, we have plus p resulting plus 3. And then we have minus p resulting minus 3. So, all these operations that we have done are now tabulated in the presentation. We have p plus q, p minus q, p into q, p a by q, right division, and then p left division q, p power q plus p minus p. Next, we will be seeing relational operators. So relational operator is nothing but we are comparing two variables or two operands. So we'll be comparing p, whether p is greater than q or less than q or equal to q. Okay. Here in MATLAB form will be slightly different from normal paper form. Instead of writing p less than or equal to q, in MATLAB will be writing less than symbol and then equal to q. Similarly, when you are dealing with p equal to q, instead of writing simply p equal to q, we have to write p equal to q. If you directly write p equal to q, then it will be an assignment statement. It means that you are storing value of q inside p. But when you are comparing whether p is equal to q or not, then you have to write p equal to q. Similarly, the symbol for not is not equal to will be like. So we shall go back to our MATLAB and check how these are resulting in the answer. Going back to MATLAB, clear the command window. You see that again we have PS3 and QS2 in the workspace. Now if we do p less than q, so 3 less than 2, it is false. So the answer will be a logical zero. It is not your simple double data type. It is a logical type of answer. So logical zero, it will result in logical zero. So logical, we have only two values, either 0 or 1. 0 implies false, 1 implies true. And then we can compare p less than or equal to q. Similarly, again we will get logical 0. Then we can compare p greater than q. Now 3 greater than 2 is true. So we will get logical 1. Similarly, p greater than or equal to q will be 1. Now we have to compare p and whether p is equal to q or not. For this we should not use p equal to q, we should use p equal to q. Now 3 is not equal to 2, so it will result in 0. Now we shall compare whether p is not equal to q or not. So p not equal to q, the symbol not is available just above your tab button. So 3 not equal to 2 is true. So it is resulting in logical 1. Now we shall see whether the relational operators are operating or working in the same way for complex numbers or not. Till now we have dealt with p and q, which are real numbers. 3 and 2 are real numbers. Now we shall see with some other variables. Complex numbers, y equal to 4 minus I, r equal to 1 plus 2y, s equal to 1 plus 2y. Now we shall compare whether x is equal to y or not. So x equal to y. 3 plus 4 is equal to 4 minus I? No. So it should result in logical 0. Yes, we got it. Now we have to check whether it is not equal to. So this shall be logical 1. Now we shall compare if r is equal to s. So what is r? R is 1 plus 2y and s is also 1 plus 2y. So it is true. Similarly, r not equal to s will result in logical 0. Now let us check if x is less than y. So before that, let us see what is there in x. X is 3 plus 4i, y is 4 minus I. Now if we check x less than y, so what x is a not a real number, it's a complex number. If you take the modulus, mod x will be equal to root over 3 square plus 4 square, that is 5, and then mod y is root over 4 square plus 1 square, that is root 17. So obviously mod y is less than x. Now let us see what happens when x is less than y statement is given. It is 1. How x is less than y? When you take the modulus, mod x is greater than mod y, right? But from this answer, we should deduce that while comparing complex numbers, only the real part of the numbers will be compared. So real part of x is 3 and real part of y is 4. So 3 less than 4 is true. Similarly, if we compare x greater than y, it will be false. So while dealing with complex numbers, especially while comparing less than or greater than, you should remember that only the real parts will be compared, not the entire complex number. So if you tabulate the results, we are taking the same data. X is equal to 3 plus 4i, y is equal to 4 minus i, so on. So here we should remember that complex numbers act only on the real part operations. So relation operators, when used with complex numbers, act only on the real part. It does not mean that we are comparing x equal to y, it is returning 0. In this case, you are not comparing real parts. Next is logical operators and function. So logical operators are nothing but your AND, OR, NOT, XOR, and so on. So we shall take some examples again in MATLAB. So data we are taking for doing logical operations, say capital A equal to 2, capital B equal to 5, capital C equal to minus 4, capital D equal to 0. We are taking this variable in such a way that they are covering both positive integers and negative integers and also 0. Okay. Now to compare, to do logical operation AND, we have to use a symbol ampersand. So A and B, this is A and B, so it is 2 and 5. Let us see what happens. It is resulting again in logical values only. It is resulting in logical 1. And then we shall see A or B. For OR, you should use the symbol A vertical slash B. This symbol is available just above your enter key. Again, it is resulting in 1. Means that it is as if both A and B are taken as 1. So in MATLAB, you should remember that any non-zero element, any non-zero number will be considered as 1. Only except 0, all other numbers will be considered as 1. Next, let us consider not C. If you remember, C is equal to minus 4. So, not C. So, C is minus 4. So, not of minus 4 is again 0. So, whether it is minus or plus, it is always 1. Not 1 will be 0. Next, we want to do XOR operation. For XOR operation, you should use an inbuilt function called XOR. If you want to do XOR of A, B, these are two operands. So, what we are going to do is nothing but XOR of A is 2, B is 5. So, both are logically 1. Means that XOR, when you are doing XOR function on two operands, when both operands are 1, then it will result in 0. So, it should result in logical 0. Yes. Then we have another inbuilt function called any. So, any of A. So, this any function is used to result in an answer 1 if any of the elements in the vector A is 1. If any of the element of a vector A is non-zero, then it will result in answer logical 1. Here, A is not a vector. However, in our example, we have taken A is equal to 2, which is a non-zero number. That's why it's resulting in 1. And then we have another inbuilt function, all of A. So, this function is used to result in logical 1 if all of the elements of vector A are non-zero elements. Here, there is only one element, which is 2. That's why we are getting logical 1 as the answer. So, what are vectors and what will be there in the vectors, will be seeing in the future classes. As of now, you need not worry about what's a vector, what's a column or a row vector or a column vector or a matrix. We'll deal in detail about vectors and matrices in the upcoming classes. Now, we shall go back to our presentation. So, these are the results A and B, A and D or B, not C, XOR function, any, and then all. Then hierarchy of operations. So, even in your school, while doing any mathematical operation, you might have known about this Bodmas rule. So, similar kind of hierarchies or precedence of operators should be considered while doing any kind of operation in MATLAB. So, these are the 9 points that you should remember. The first preference is for parenthesis or your bracket. So, parenthesis, contents of parenthesis are evaluated first, starting from the innermost parenthesis and then working outwards. Second precedence is transpose. If there is any function like transpose or to the power of or conjugate or matrix power, those operations will be given the second priority. Next, third priority is for unary plus, unary minus and logical NOT. Fourth priority is for your Bodmas rule, that is your multiplication, right division, then left division, matrix multiplication and so on. And the fifth hierarchy is addition and subtraction, or that comes after multiplication and division. Next, sixth one is column operator. Column operator, we shall see what's the use of column operator in the upcoming classes. For time being, you only remember that column operator is having the sixth higher in the hierarchy. Next is less than or equal to, equal to, equal to, not equal to, and so on. Finally, you have logical and then after that, you will get logical OR. So logical AND is having more priority than logical OR. So all the operations in MATLAB will be done only as per this hierarchy. So number one is having highest preference, number nine is having lowest preference. Okay, so this is high priority. So when you are doing, this is low. Okay. Next, we have built-in functions. So we have used some built-in functions already, like XOR. Similarly, if you have a function, like if you want to find out logarithm of a square root of something, you can use built-in functions like log, sqrt, and so on. A function may be used in arithmetic operations, very similar to the variable name. Function may be used as argument of another function. So here you can see that the square root is becoming an argument for the logarithmic function, sqrt. So all the functions appearing in arithmetic expression are evaluated first. So in the hierarchy of operation, even the functions are given the preference. So argument of a function is computed first in the order of to evaluate a function. So if there are any trigonometric functions, by default the argument is in radians, the angle is in radians. So all the trigonometric functions are having arguments in radians. If you want to convert them into degrees, you have different functions like sin d, cos d, tan d, and so on. Or you may use the, you already seen that rad to dig or dig to rad, you may use. Then these are some of the inbuilt functions like ABS. ABS is find out the magnitude or the absolute value of any complex number. Any we have seen, and we have seen angle. So angle is used to find out the angle in radians. All we have seen, A tan means R tan or your tan inverse. A tan to cot to pole, we have already seen converting Cartesian to polar coordinates. CONG is for finding out the conjugate. Factorial. So for doing factorial, you not write lengthy program. Like you know, C, you have an inbuilt function factorial. So MATLAB has been generously added huge number of inbuilt functions. So if you are knowing them, it's well and good. Even if you do not know, we may write a program to find out the values. IMAD we have used already to find out the imaginary part. Log to find out the natural logarithm. This is log to the base. This is logical OR. Then pole to cart, polar to Cartesian. Real to find out the real part. SQR to find out the square root. Tan D to find out the tangent of an angle in degrees. XOR function, exclusive OR, we have already seen. Now, assignment statement. So you can assign any expression to a given variable by this statement. Variable name equal to expression. So in this statement, you may use or you may not use the semicolon. If you are using the semicolon, the echo of the output of the statement will be suppress in the command window. It will not be displayed. If you are not using the semicolon, the echo will be on and you may be seeing the output in the command window. So first, the expression on the right hand side of the equal to will be evaluated first, then only it will be assigned to the variable name. It's not from left to right. First the expression will be evaluated and then only it will be assigned to variable name. Now we have to do some illustrative programs, so like practice programs. So first program is write a program to convert temperature given in centigrade to degrees Fahrenheit. So we are given a temperature 35.4 degrees. Okay. So first we shall go back to the MATLAB to do this problem. So I have already done this problem. I'll just showcase. So I have written a MATLAB file, temp.com. Okay, so in this program what I have done, I have initiated the centigrade value. In the question it is given 35.4, so I have written centigrade is equal to 35.4. I have initiated the centigrade value, and then Fahrenheit. To find out the Fahrenheit, we have to know the equation. You know that Fahrenheit temperature is equal to centigrade temperature into 9/5 plus 32. I have written the same thing. These two are assignment statements. First statement, I have assigned 35.4 value to the centigrade. The second, I have assigned an expression. This expression, we have a variable centigrade, we have constant 9/5 and 32. So upon running this, we'll be getting, here we are getting in the command window 95.72, and then we shall go back to the next problem. This is a very simple program. So next we have to find out the MATLAB. We have to write a MATLAB statement to calculate sum of the series. So S is equal to 1 minus x square by 2 factorial plus x power 4 by 4 factorial minus x power 6 by 6 factorial plus x power 8 by 8 factorial for x is equal to 1.5. This problem can be done in two ways. Either you directly write the entire statement in a single expression, but that will be clumsy because you have to use another inbuilt function called factorial. You have already seen the factorial function, and writing it will be much complex. So you want to reduce that, we may split the expression into different parts. Let us go back to MATLAB and do the problem. So I have already done this problem. I will open that. So here you may see that first what I have done, I have initiated the value of x. X is equal to 1.5. Then what I have done, I have split the expression into four parts. X1 is equal to x square by factorial 2. X2 is equal to x power 4 by factorial 4. X3 is equal to x power 6 by factorial 6. And then X4 is equal to x power 8 by factorial 8. So these X1, X2, X3, X4 are four different variables. And then what I have done, S is equal to 1 minus x1 plus x2 minus x3 plus x4. So I have simplified the complex expression into a simple expression. However, the disadvantage here is that we are initiating four different variables. So it is occupying a lot of space here. So let us run and see the answer. So answer is S is equal to 0.0708. You may directly write the entire expression in single statement instead of again creating four variables also. Then also you will get the same answer. But however, for the user, it will be a complex statement. Now, I have assignment or the to-do problems for you. I have to find out the values of A, B, C and D are given. Some values are given: minus 190.5 into 10 power minus 2, 14.6 into 10 power 3, 0.0056 and 456.28. You have to write a program to evaluate F1. You have to find out F1, where F1 is equal to AB by CD plus A into B. F2 is equal to A by BC minus D by A. Given the radius of circle R is equal to 5 centimeters, second question, try to find the circumference and area. So you may use a simple formula. Circumference is nothing but your perimeter 2 pi r. Area is pi r square. So hint also I am giving now itself. So you have to do these two problems and write your answers in the comments. Thank you.